We have become so busy, there's always so much to do in so little time. But many of us make this to-do list, which really helps us through the day. I personally feel so satisfied when I'm able to check most of the things on my to-do list. But then someday, when I'm somewhere in the second or third point of my to-do list, by the way, which I forced myself to complete, I feel like, hey, wait a minute, what am I doing? Am I just going through the motions? Am I just going to do this for the rest of my life? Is this what people call success? If yes, then why doesn't it feel like success? I don't know if you have been there, but I have been there many times. To-do lists are great, and I can hardly function without them. They kind of engage the cogwheels of our daily responsibilities together and enable us to function effectively. But there is something amiss. Most of the time, our to-do lists are all about what is extremely urgent, something that our job or our boss demands. For instance, sending some emails, coordinating a meeting, making some phone calls that your boss delegated to you. Or at home, it could be laundry, dishes, cooking, etc., which are vital for keeping our job or survival, but don't help us in our career advancement or fulfilling our dreams. However, most of us are entangled in what I call office chores, as dictated by our to-do list. Thankfully, I came across this amazing concept of success list in a book titled The One Thing by Keller Gary. As he spoke of replacing the to-do list with success list. Success list is the list of things that you need to do to advance your career or fulfill your dreams directly. Not like, okay, I need to keep my job to advance my career, so I must take on more workplace chores to impress my boss, so that comes under my success list. No, that's not what we are looking at here. To advance my career, I need to perhaps learn a new skill or something, and that would be unique to your job. And if you're wondering why am I discussing this self-help kind of topic in Healthy Twist, then listen to this. When we are making efforts towards the goals we personally cherish and value, then our brain releases dopamine, a happiness hormone that helps us ward off anxiety and depression over a period of time. So this is for our mental and emotional health. But removing to-do list as suggested by Keller Gary, was not feasible for me. So I created my own hybrid concept. So I made both. Every day, just as I made my to-do list, I also made my success list. On the same page, dividing the page into right and left half to symbolize the equality in priority. So I'm a college professor, so my to-do list goes like this: mark attendance, make class schedule, take lecture, prepare question paper, counsel students who failed, and so on. All of these things are an integral part of my job, but not for my career advancement. My success list goes like this: choose topic for my next research, plan how to take the recently attended workshop forward, speak to interdisciplinary researchers about the prospects of collaboration, etc. This my job may not demand, but since I wish to earn a name and place in my profession globally, I want to do it. Similarly, every profession will have its own success list, and each person in that profession may have their own. So think about how you wish to advance your career. What are your dreams? Where would you like to see yourself 5 years from now? A cliche phrase. And then plan backwards. Break it down till today. And that, my friend, is your success list. By the way, the first time you do this exercise, you will need about 1 hour. So do it on a holiday or something. Once you have both the list, look at your to-do list. Check if there is anything on this list which someone else in your office would be willing to do with 80% efficiency from your standards. If yes, give it away. Second, is there anything in this list that you're doing just to be in good books of others or to please others? For me, it would be like formatting question paper before giving it to the clerk, instead of letting him or her format it. If yes, remove it from the list. Third, rearrange the task in the order of priority and delegate the time each task is likely to take. Now make sure that 80% of your total time goes to your to-do list. You can leave all the tasks in your to-do list which are spilling out of this 80% time. Now come to your success list. Break it down so that at least one of the tasks can be completed in 20% of your time. Now you are ready with your success list. The catch is that you will start your day by completing your success list first. Yes, you heard me. Initially, you will feel anxious and take a while, but a week later, you will become a pro. Eventually, you will work your way to devoting 50% of your time to your success list. In this process, your colleagues may see a change in you. Some may be displeased with you as you stop being a dumpyard of office chores and have started reaching out for help, but that's okay. I have been doing this since quite some time, for both office and home, and I have been able to do a lot more of what I would like to do for my own success as I define it. So never let busyness get in the way of your dreams. Please do try it. I would love to hear from you. Like, share, subscribe. See you all.